Today, friends, we are going to use Tinkercad to make a part and save me a buck. So let's get cracking.
All right, so here's the problem. We've got this part, and I could not get all of the old broom handle out of it, but I still want to reuse it because the handle's fine. It was 10 bucks to buy a new one. I think I've got a strategy. So we're going to make a sleeve using ABS and Tinkercad to keep these two together. Step one is to grab a caliper. I've got mine set to millimeters, and my plan is to build a sleeve over this. Now I've hammered this a bit, and you'll see that it changes in every direction. 26.2, 25.8, 25. So I'm going to go with that 26.2 or 26.3 as my base measurement. I'm also going to make the sleeve come down this way, about 35. And then finally, we're looking at a little more than 22.3 for the tube.
So now we're going to visit Tinkercad.com. You can simply choose sign in with Google. It is totally free and super easy to work with. We're going to click on designs, and you can see I've got a ton of designs here. This is where you'd hit create, and we want to make a brand new 3D design. I like to start projects by naming them, that way they're easier to find. I'm going to call this one Broom Fix. When I click down here, it is already saved. We usually build using solids in Tinkercad. Notice I just clicked, brought that out, drug another one in. This is the normal process. Real quickly, I'm going to back out and I'm just going to show you that it is already saved. You can see it gives us a view of it right here. And to get back in, we simply hit Tinker This. If this is your first time checking Tinkercad out, I've got an entire day one playlist. You can find it using the bit.ly I'm showing right here or the cards in this video. All right, so let's switch and let's build the part I was talking about. I'm going to hit delete, and if you look right here, we have got a six-sided polygon. This is the idea for what we want to build. Of course, we need the right measurements. If you look at this, it shows us 20 on this angle, and that's from this point to this point. I kept measuring across this side, which is not what they show us, so I had to go back and measure, and I came up with 29.2 for the measurement I want. So I'm going to add just a little bit of fluff to that. We're going to do shift stretch, and instead of 29.2, I'm going to type 30.8. That way there's a little bit of gap all the way around this. I'm going to hit T for transparent. I want to take this line and I want to put it right on one of those dots. Notice I'm having trouble lining that up. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to shut off the nudge. That way I can get it as close as I can. You can turn on front view to double check and left view to double check. Of course, if you hit F to fit view, it lines it up as well. So I'm happy with that. So now I'm going to go back to a perspective view, and I want to put the sketch tool right in line with that spot. So I'm going to set it in this 20 by 20 grid. Now I want my snap back on. I'm going to set it to size 1. And bingo, it snaps right in there. Now what that did for us is it lined up these points for easy tracing, or as easy as it can be with these numbers not being perfect. I'm going to switch this to 0.1 because I want it to be close, and I'm simply going to click on that spot, then this spot. Once again, you can zoom in to get really, really close and repeat those steps all the way around our polygon. And one last click to wrap it up. Now we're not going to hit finish sketch yet because we want to switch to a stroke. I'm going to make it a little bit stronger by making it a width of 3. And then instead of the inside, I want this to be on the outside. And then I think I'm going to stick with the sharp corners. You can, of course, mess with the round and bevel as well if you want to. Finally hit finish sketch. Bang! Just like that, sleeve created. Of course, I did say I was going to change that height to something close to 35. We can take this part we used as a template, and we can delete it. All right, now we need to build the tube. The tube needs to be 23. We're going to do it with the sketch. Once again, just double check. I want my nudge set to 1 to make this easier. And I'm going to set it on a 20 by 20 grid spot. To build this part, we need a tube that is 23 in diameter. So check it out. We're going to simply make any size that we want. double click on those. And then when we double click and double click, we can simply take the number and change it to what we want. 23 and 23. Bang, we've got the exact circle we need. I'm going to click over here on the width. Once again, I'm going to make it 3. And then, of course, we're going to set it to the outside, just like before. When we're done, we can hit Finish Sketch. I'm going to use Cruise, the letter C, to put this right up on top of this shape right here. Of course, then we can grab the two, choose L for a line, and choose Center and Center. I'm going to choose to make this 40 tall, just like that. So that fits pretty smooth, but there are little gaps here. We're going to fix that with the cone. Simply cruise the cone out, set it right on top. We are going to do a base radius of 16 and press enter. I'm also going to set the sides to 6, so it's the same as our shape. If we grab all of that and do L for a line, we want it to be centered and centered. I'm going to simply switch this to 18.8, so it's close to that edge, but it does not stick over. I'm also going to take the height and make it 30 and press enter. And then we need to cut out the middle. Once again, just bring out a whole cylinder. We're going to set it down and we're going to shift stretch it. The number that we need is 23 and press enter. I'll make it a little bit taller. And then we just need to shift select the purple one and that hole. L for a line with the purple one being the boss. Notice I still did not stretch it tall enough. Make it past it. And now if we shift select the purple one and the hole, two shapes, control G to group, bang. We have got a nice transition for our part. I'm going to grab it and I'm going to lay it down on this edge. 90 degrees is simply 4 clicks. You can see there are 22.5 degrees per click. If you hold down shift, it's 45 degrees. With it all selected, D to drop, and bang. There's our part. Now this part would not print well. We need some support. I'm going to simply do it with a rectangle. Remember, this thing is 40, so I'll type it like that. I'm going to do a length of 12. That's this measurement up here. And then, of course, the height. I'm going to choose 4 and press enter. Same trick. Select the two, L for a line. Let's click on that and choose center and choose the front spot. Now, I am really confident in my measurements. If I was not, I would print this ring super small and this hexagon small so I could test them ahead of time. Right now, though, I'm simply going to grab this, choose export. I'm going to use the STL, and I'm going to name it Broom Fix. I already had one that name before. I don't care. I'm going to simply replace it. So now let's bounce to Bambu Studio. We're going to hit create brand new project. Let's find that file. There is the broom fix. When it comes in, I am going to once again switch to my ABS. Generic. I'm going to use the 0.2 strength and let's slice that plate and check it out. We will have a finished part in less than an hour. How cool is that? I think because of this opening right here, I'm going to back up and go to supports, and I'm going to enable the tree supports. Once again, slice plate, and even with the supports, we are just barely past an hour. Finally, let's click print plate, double check the filament, and send it to the 3D printer.
All right, so here we are with our finished part. This slides on here, and of course, the broom handle is going to slide in here. And I'm going to use some Gorilla Grip, which is like E6000, to get it all fixed together. I'll start by putting some glue inside this part. And then we'll put some glue inside this part. Slide that one in just like that. And slide this end in just like this. And I can't show you, but we're just gonna tap that on the floor to get it firmly seated. How cool is that? Now, if this doesn't work, I could also drill some holes through to add support that way, but I think it's gonna be absolutely awesome.
All right, so let's do a quick wrap up. Of course, first things first, if you're trying to fix something, make sure you measure it and get it accurately. Once you do that, you can find the right pieces to fix it with. Today, I used the sketch tool. It has the awesome outer line that let us make that part in a jiffy. If you're just starting out with the sketch tool, make sure you check that playlist up above. If you're just starting out with Tinkercad, make sure you check out my day one Tinkercad playlist. I do quickly want to say thank you to everybody that supports me via YouTube memberships. Don't forget there are three different levels of support starting as low as $5 a month. With any level of support, you get early access to videos. Also, a huge shout out to my Patreon supporters. Love how that group is growing. It has a fantastic messaging area. You can ask questions, get support, gain skills. Of course, you can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget every time you hit that like button, hype button, share a video, add a comment down below, or click subscribe. You're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day and keep tinkering.